alley for a local teenager whose death is being compared to the death of Trayvon Martin.
Year-old Corey Stingley died in December after he was wrestled to the ground by customers while shoplifting at a West Allis convenience store. 12 News' Terry Sater is live there, and Terry, you learned new information on what led up to his death.
Well, that's right, Kathy. I learned from Corey Stingley's dad tonight that he's seen the medical examiner's report, and he says his son died from asphyxiation after a violent struggle with customers here at this West Allis convenience store.
What do we want? Justice! When do we want it? Now!
Craig Stingley leads a rally on behalf of his 16-year-old son, Corey, who died last December in West Allis.
Put his all into everything he did, so he was an excellent student.
Stingley says the West Allis Nathan Hale High School student earned a 4.0 on his last report card. But soon after, he'd be accused of shoplifting at this convenience store, was held down and put in a chokehold by three customers and stopped breathing.
I mean, it was a bad choice on his part, I say, as his father, but it was a worse choice by those who took his life.
Corey's varsity teammates marched and prayed for justice, including Jordan Plantico and Andrew Bulo.
He's like a brother to us, and I don't like seeing what's going on. Like I said, it doesn't make me feel good that he's gone and nothing's happened for 7 months.
I'm never going to see him again, and it breaks my heart, and there's just something needs to be done about this.
From the roar of motorcycle support to the silent power of prayer, Corey's loved ones wait for the voice of justice. And I spoke with an attorney for one of the men who held Corey Stingley down. They declined to comment tonight, but the DA's office tells me it'll be at least a week before we learn the results of that secret John Doe investigation into Corey Stingley's death. Live in West Allis, Terry Sater, WISN 12 News.